One thing which I really need to show you guys is the background music. By default, the background music is Glaze's Rainbow Factory, the instrumental version of that. But if you want, you can put your own WAV files in here. As soon as you click the browse button here, it shows this nag screen. I really, really want to make sure that bronies respect other bronies here. So I have this nag screen. Please show respect to the wishes of those of us who make music. I realize part of the appeal of this software is being able to put brony tunes to a video game. Still, please don't use music without the composer's permission. And it's true, I did get Glaze's permission to use Rainbow Factory before I started. Now, as part of this, I actually recorded myself singing the first verse of the USA National Anthem. Just so that I'd have something to compare it to. But before I put this in place, I want to show you what happens when you click Cancel. You get the option to use the default music. If you click Yes, then it'll be the default music. On the other hand, if after you click Cancel, you click No, don't use the default music. It asks you, do you want to use no music at all? If you click Yes, then it blanks this out. I'm not sure why you wouldn't want any music. Maybe it's a horror game where nothing is scarier. Or maybe it's just, a level that you're just dinking around with. But you have the option of no music, you have the option of default music. I'll just select USA National Anthem and show you what happens if you decide, okay, I clicked Browse, but I don't actually want to change anything. Click Cancel. Then when it says use default music, click no. Then when it says use no music at all, you click no and it won't change it. So that's how you get default music, that's how you get no music, that's how you choose your own music. So I'll save this as escape. Let's call it escape zap test. Yes. And no, I don't want to pack it. I'll explain packing in a later part. So, load up escape zap test. And have to switch the music on before you hear it. On second thought, you don't really need to hear me fail at hitting high notes. That's enough for the music. That gives you an idea how it works. There's one more thing to show you guys before I begin on the goal, which is actually how I did everything in commentary. Actually, I have a couple of different sound effects to show you guys. They're extremely simple. This one is batteries in a small plastic baggie shaken in front of the microphone. Extremely simple. Another one is actually scissors snipped open and shut right in front of the microphone. Not much point to them other than having a sound effect to show. And let's see, another one. Yes. A bottle of Tums shaken in front of the microphone. Again, these are just random sound effects for the purpose of having a sound effect to put in here. When you create one of these radios, you have the option of putting a label on it. So here's one that's a bottle of Tums. And it has Tums written in CN on there. Since you could have more than one tutorial radio in the same room, set it up so that you can label them so that you can tell them apart. Put Bat there. And it's possible to put more than one radio that has the same commentary in the same room. I figure there's no real reason for forbidding that, and there's a reason why you would want to have it there too, because It's possible to build a room so that one area of the room is cordoned off from the other room, say, a solid set of blocks right here that don't allow you to jump up into this area or jump down into this area. Maybe you'll want the same commentary to be available regardless of which part of the room the player is in. So for that reason, it's beneficial to be able to put more than one radio into the room that has the same commentary on it. Create another one for the scissors. And these buttons do let you preview the sound. Actually, yellow isn't going to show up very well. I'll go with dark green. Dark green doesn't show up that well either. Oh well. There's also commentary doors, which work exactly the same way as doors on the widgets, items, and doors layer, except they only appear when the player is in commentary mode. This commentary sign, it's exactly the same as widgets on the widget layer or on the foreground widget layer. The only catch to them is that they only appear when commentary mode is on. This allows you to put in captions that the player will only be able to see in commentary mode. And this button is again the edit button. The move selection forward and move selection backward buttons really only work with the widgets, but they can work with them. Some of these controls look familiar from other layers. The duplicate button works exactly the same way. The erase button works exactly the same way. So that's it for the demonstration for how to place commentary objects. Let's see what they're like in the game. It's possible to restore a game that will get you into commentary mode. I'll try that now. This'll work. Eventually. Developer commentary on. Load up escape. There's Twilight in her little raincoat. So here we are in commentary mode. I'm going to switch this music on so that you can find out what happens. Same batteries sound effect there. And it's the bottle of Tums. So yeah, that's about it for commentary.